I don't know if I want what she's got, but open the door before I kick it down.
Should have known she'd send a bruiser after me. Damned if I don't rue the day I saved her scrawny little hide. Inadvertently, I befriended a bloodhound in the process. All right, okay. We can discuss this like the level-headed folk that we are. Seems I've got to do something before Ellie goes jabbering my business to anyone with one ear and an intent to listen.
I could be in trouble with this.
The truth is, I'm not sick. But if you repeat what I'm about to tell you to anyone, I will deny it with my dying breath. You, ain't with the board, are you?
No.
See, I owe them a lot. I might have missed a payment or two, and the other night I swear someone was following me back to my room. So I hold up here to lay low.
What did you do that got you into trouble?
What? No, I didn't do anything. I'm a law-abiding denizen of this ship, I swear.
Yet you think the board had someone follow you, and now you're hiding out.
Think? No. I recognize a contracted killer when I see one, thank you. In my line of work, that's a skill you develop during week one, assuming you want to keep breathing. All right, I'll fess this part up too, if it means you'll help me. I'm a thief. I specialize in particularly high-end and historically valuable items. 3 weeks back, I caught rumor that the Blood Tear Diamond, last worn by an heiress on the Lost Hope, had surfaced for the first time in 70 years.
So you stole it?
If I had, you think I'd be hiding out in the med bay? I was gonna steal it, lined up Udom as my buyer. He paid half up front to finance the operation. Let's just say things went sideways about the time I got my hands on the diamond, and it crumbled to stardust in my palm.
What?
Anywho, I barely made it out with my life, and nary a plan to make back Udom's deposit I'd spent.
Well, Ellie asked me to help you, so that's what I plan on doing.
Udom Bedford's the board guy on the station. He'd know how I stand with them. If you can square things for me, I'd owe you one even bigger than Ellie owes me.
So, you're not really sick. So unless the people that work here in the med bay are all incompetent, they know you're not sick, so how are you getting them to do you know some of these people personally? Are they doing a favor for you? I'll talk to Udom for you.
Thanks for helping me with the board. You're a real pal. Or I guess I should say, Ellie is one, huh?
Yes, indeed.
You're sure no one followed you? Is it all clear, or am I still a wanted woman?
Why does Ellie think she owes you?
Ha! Oh, you should ask her that. She'll love it. By which I mean she'll probably have an apoplectic fit.
She didn't tell me, but I can always ask again. Ellie was pretty emphatic that you two aren't friends. What's going on here?
Oh, that's just how Ellie is. According to her, she don't need no one or anything to get by in life.
Oh.
She can deny it all she wants, but we know each other. More than just as passing acquaintances. We've helped each other. Sometimes we even like each other.
Sometimes.
Lone pirates don't live too long, and it ain't weak to have a friend or two.
Alright, you'd best lay low for a little while longer, Jessie. Alright, let's see if we can get out of here. Running out of juice on this thing. I don't know how you two got by without that shroud.
Keep hanging around and I'll begin to think you're here for me. What can I do for you? You have yourself a day then.
Hi.
Any word on Jessie?
Remind me, what happened between you two again?
Let's just say she did me a favor, and now I owe her. So, did you find her, or what?
I'm really curious. I wanted to find out exactly the specifics, but, well, she's in debt to the board and thinks someone's after her. I'll handle it.
Good luck. The board's got an office on the promenade just before engineering. You can't miss it.
What seems to be the problem? Take care.
Okay. Gotta love that holographic shroud thing. Alright, we haven't been back here.
BNP, I can't believe it's not forced. It's unbelievable how good it is.
I imagine you would know your CMPs.
CMP chicken and potatoes. At CMP, we know our CMP. CMP pancake mix. Now requires no mixing. Seriously, don't mix it. CMP near maple syrup. It's near this complete breakfast.
Near it.
CMP Forested Baked Beans. When you need to eat and run, Forested Baked Beans is the only one. CMP Borst Pocket. Can be microwaved in 2.5 seconds. Borst Pocket.
Microwaved.
CMP Borstwurst. It's not the worst unless it's Borstwurst.
It's not the worst.
BNP, I can't believe it's not forced. Unbelievable how good it is. BNP Borstwurst. It's not the worst unless it's Borstwurst.
Public terminal. Recent users. Callahan M. signed in. B. Everson is logged out. T. Oyama logged out. Access user Callahan M. Should I know who Callahan M. is? Displaying recent messages. The hat. Is this the same guy back at the... Where's the moon? It's not a hat. It's a complete, like, face covering. I keep telling you, the hat doesn't fit right. There's something wrong with it. How many people have worn this thing before me? You made your spacer's choice when you signed the employment contract. Hi, Mom. Are you okay, honey? Hope you're doing well, Mom. Thought I'd check in. Engineers visit the shop a bunch. I remember when I used to turn a wrench back home on Terra 2. Lilya Hagen over in Sublight told me that I could always pursue a career in salvage if this thing doesn't work out. Please give Dad and the others a hug from me. Mom, it's really great that we can stay in touch like this. Little reminders of home are more important than ever. Enjoy the quality Spacer's Choice goods I sent. You can get ones just like them at home, but I figure you might appreciate me getting the company discount and all. Yes, Martin, that's his name. That's the guy with the hat. Public notices. The heat. I know it's bad. As the one whose office is closest to our radiators, you can imagine why I want to take those three showers every day. I hear you. We've got eyes on the problem, and hands, and tools. It's a mechanical problem with a mechanical solution. In the meantime, enjoy some additional water rations and take breaks. You deserve them. If you're thirsting for cooler air, talk to your closest engineer about spots with favorable circulation. JT. Seeking contractor, Sublight Salvage. Seeking ethically flexible spacer with Stellar Bay landing clearance. Payment in exchange for return of legal salvage, sorry, not lethal. Details given upon acceptance of contract. Active warrants, prior convictions, no questions asked. Our background checks filter out criminal red flags. Plausible deniability is the Sublight way. See Lilya Hagen for details. What is it saying? Whorehouse? Where is my brain? Warehouse next to the Spratwurst joint, second floor. Loitering on board property is strictly prohibited. Do not delete. The Halcyon Holdings corporate office and its environs are for conducting official board business only. Anyone found misusing board properly will be fined accordingly. Board property includes, but is not limited to, Halcyon Holdings' office here on Groundbreaker, the space directly in front of my desk, the space directly behind my desk, my doorway, my berth, and more importantly, my stairs. Thank you for your cooperation, Udon Bedford, Certified Liaison. P.S. Please note that the next spacer caught drinking on the stairs outside the embassy may find themselves on the rude side of an airlock. P.P.S. This is the third time I've had to post this message, and I'm sick and tired of it. I will not hesitate to open a board-sanctioned investigation into your behavior, and when you are caught, punish you accordingly. Felix Millstone. Oh, he's the guy outside that we met. Felix Millstone.
Going.
Where's Sublight?
Just plugged the last of the O2 leaks. I'm ready for downtime.
Nasty encounter you had down there. Sorry, man. Fucking pirates, right? How you planning to spend your night off? Some lonely young Mardette with starships in their eyes?
He and I get in some quality time with Vera's stock.
Let me know when you're heading out. We'll get drinks the night before. Salvage is a family business. We've got each other's backs.
Okay. Oh! I hit the wrong key. I've been wasting a few of those lately. I don't like that.
You ever hard up for work? Try Sublight Salvage. Good pay if you're flexible.
Morally flexible. Hi.
If you're hungry, you've come to the right place. I've got a fresh ground batch of Spratwurst cooking. They're terrified to lock in the juices. How about a grinder's dozen?
What's Spratwurst exactly? Do I not want to know?
You know what sprats are?
Yes.
Space rats. The laboratories of Spacer's Choice found a use for this limitless frontier resource.
Huh.
Sprat meat is plenty tasty when properly prepared. We grind them up in sausages, then terrify them in their own juices.
So that's what Sprat stands for? Space rat? I did not know that. What does terrafry mean?
Terrafrying is a Spacer's Choice brand secret. A mix of 13 herbs and spices, plus a dash of modern chemistry.
Is Spratwurst your own invention or what?
Legally? No. The terrafrying method was developed and marketed by Spacer's Choice. Between you, me, and this grinder, I've been through lean times. If there's one thing you learn on tramp freighters, it's how to make near anything edible. Might be that this old space hand put a few words in the right ears, and could be that Spacer's Choice liked sticking it to C&P by R&D-ing our own special meat.
Is Spratwurst like Borstwurst?
Absolutely not. Spratwurst and all related terms are registered trademarks of Spacer's Choice. Boar, the other meat, is a registered trademark of C&P. Everyone knows our company and theirs are nothing alike.
I wasn't asking about the companies are similar, but more the... never mind.
Just as well. Near about time for me to go check on the trap. I mean, to unload another crate of farm-fresh sprats.
I ask you a question.
As long as you don't mind me grinding Spratwurst while we talk. Little things don't make themselves chewy. At least not yet. I'm sure modern science will find a way.
Never mind then.
Just as well. Fresh from the grinder, any hour.
Alright, so I can buy... Terrified Spratwurst. Farm-raised Sprat... deboned and finely ground and fried in hot oil. 8 pieces. Oh, what does it say? Less than eight fresh morsels. So there's not 8, there's less than 8. Microwave at your own risk. Finest herbs and spices. Try it with double mustard. And then she's selling dehydrated water tablets. Pardon me. Let me go look at Sublight Salvage and Shipping.
Sublight Salvage. Their front looks surprisingly on the up and up.
You reckon we can shop here, or is it all spoke for?
Oh no, I think I'm looking for a job.
Sublight for life. Corporations never lifted a finger for me.
Of course they wouldn't. They're corporations.
Miss Lilya takes good care of us, see? The authorities stay off our trails.
Can I use this terminal? Warehouse terminal. Messages. From Lilya Hagen. Subject, don't run. To Sublight Company All. We lost another contractor to the UDL gunship. This is your daily reminder that legitimate businesses don't run from the authorities. And that is what we are. Stay calm. Present your papers. If you get tangled up in the courts, I will personally bail you out. Anyone see Hawthorne lately? I could use some reliable help. She knew Hawthorne. Okay, LH. Lilya Hagen. Subject, Fallbrook Shipments. Unlike most of you sprats, Catherine is bringing Sublight a consistent income. Till I say so, you're to treat her as an extension of my desk. Speaking of which, Tobias, order an extension for my desk. Fallbrook Shipment. Purpleberry Liquor, lots. Spectrum Vodka, even more than that. Erotica, generic. The locals aren't picky. Erotica exotic, except for the ones who are. Space Cake Surprise. I don't know what this is, but it was on last month's order list, so either track some down or do your best in the kitchen. Black Hole Holcomb. Signed Tossball Poster. Any relation? To our own Parvati? P.S. Tobias, where are we with that desk extension? I'm Lilya Hagen. Subject, this week in Salvage. My scanner says the Mardettes impounded a freelancer ship after their captain misbehaved. The crew dropped so many bits at Vera's place that they can't afford to lift the impound. Whoever gets me salvage rights gets to sit quietly in my office and watch a professional work. One of ours had an altercation with one of theirs. Lost another contractor. Scrapped the ship. Dedicated a tenth of the salvage to funeral expenses. I take care of my people. A little sprat told me that a crate of spoiled sissy pork ended up at the bottom of a Monarch Canyon. Let's see how much we can sell. Speaking of which, no one eat at Anticleo's stall until I say so. Something in the kitchen's gone bad. The next time one of us finds an abandoned ship and decommissions it, they had better dispatch a ground team to the debris field before the marauders have their turn. Just because we're salvagers doesn't mean we have to be scavengers. This Lilya sounds like quite a character.
Salvage is a family business. You've got each other's backs.
Okay.
Who wants to play an impromptu tossball match?
In the elevator? No one? Not in the elevator, Max. Lilya, I presume?
Welcome to Sublight Salvage and Shipping.
Oh no.
Legitimate business for legitimate consumers.
Sorry, you're a guy.
You the one flying the unreliable?
How'd you know?
Money. We got it. The stevedores want it. I'll take that as a yes. Miss Lilya's been expecting you. I'll unlock the door.
So, you're a Sublight employee, obviously.
Sure am. A few years back, they got me started on simple acquisitions. You know those latches they put on cargo bays ain't worth a damn? These days, I stick to HQ and look after Miss Lilya.
Alright. Well, thanks.
As always, I am at your disposal. Anything you'd like to discuss?
There's some things I don't understand about your religion.
Yes.
Besides the grand architect and the plan, what else do you believe?
Scientism, as its name implies, believes that nature abhors equality. The strong survive, and the weak perish for the betterment of the whole.
Darwinism.
And reason, not emotion, is the seat of all morality. Wisdom means accepting the vicissitudes of life with grace and dignity.
Now there's a word. Vicissitude. Sounds like a cruel belief system.
I prefer to think of it as looking at reality for what it truly is, not how we'd like it to be. Yes?
Parvati?
Are we gonna get in trouble today? Not that I want to, just seems to happen around you, that's all.
I'll try to behave. Hello? Miss Hagen?
So you're the new captain in town. I was hoping you'd make your way to my office. Saves me the work of hunting you down. Lilya Hagen, CEO and Executive Director of Aggressive Operations. I'm guessing you already know about Sublight, otherwise you wouldn't have come.
Groundbreaker Security told me Sublight has a pretty sketchy reputation.
You clutch those pearls awfully tight for someone flying a dead man's ship.
Huh.
It's nice to see the Unreliable again. Useful ship. Hawthorne was my contractor. I'd recognize that leaky boat of his anywhere.
Good thing I didn't tell him I'm Hawthorne. I didn't kill him.
I didn't ask. I have a salvage job for someone light on corporate ties with a reliable set of wings, but there's a catch.
There is always a catch.
I was about to say that.
If you have a nav key to Stellar Bay, the job's yours. Interested?
I don't have an nav key, but can I still take the job?
I like that initiative, but ease back on the throttle. Gladys at the Rest and Go might have what you need.
I've met her.
If there's anything else, be quick about it. Time is bits.
Yeah, I have to do something else for her first. I take it Sublight isn't strictly a salvage operation?
These days, the scrap business all but runs itself. Gives me the time to expand our interests into other sectors, where I can let my hair down.
What kinds of other sectors does Sublight pursue other than salvage and shipping?
Our field is persuasive acquisitions. At least that's how my legal advisors tell me to phrase it.
Huh.
Not all of our salvage is abandoned when we find it. Sometimes it takes a polite conversation and a shot across the bow. You know, legal formalities.
I'm gonna wink and nod.
Good girl. Knew you'd understand.
How organized is this business?
Very. I have this thing about numbers in spreadsheets. Grids in general. I like to think of myself as the last honest businesswoman in Halcyon, but I'll settle for being the most organized one.
You're pretty honest about Sublight's criminal side.
Hey, careful with the C word around here.
Sorry.
I like to keep things above board, and that kind of talk only makes trouble.
Right.
Sublight occupies a legal blind spot. No one knows what we're licensed to do, and that gives our little business some freedom. But let's not tempt fate.
Can I ask any other questions?
Ask. I have nothing to hide.
Actually, I don't have anything else to ask.
Be seeing you. Make sure you aren't followed on your way out.
Huh. Can I take a look at this? Sublight. Legitimate business. Contractors. If the authorities are on your heels, our legal team has pre-approved you to recite this passage from our colonist trading rights. Pursuant to regulations following internally preserved Borst, such a business entity... Such a business entity would therefore be entitled to gather, maintain, and ultimately dispose of decommissioned agricultural hardware and accessories for profit or convenience. The short version, if we handle potted meat, we can legally salvage tractors and tractor parts. That's why I keep a can of Boris in the Sublight-owned safe deposit box off-world, and why the goods you bring in are catalogued as farm equipment. Everything we do is perfectly legal. Now, go bring home some bacon. Hi.
Miss Lilya takes good care of us, see? The authorities stay off our tails.
There's an enemy back there. Are you aware of this? Always back there somewhere. I suppose they wouldn't like us picking that lock. What's this? Dangerous Frontiers by Ophelia Sweeney. It is intriguing how we devoted our resources to the stars when there were still so many problems to be solved on Earth. Exposing our fragile species to the breath of the cosmos renders settlers and spacers alike vulnerable to the mysteries of other worlds. The fate of an outbound civilization could hinge on a single miscalculation, an unobserved variable, and any number of alien catastrophes. Recklessness and impatience are, perhaps, hardwired features of humanity, and not errors in our genes, as others might imply. Is that a novel or something? Alright, well, we'll be on our way. See ya.
You really in jail, Mr. Max? And you were our vicar?
Yes, but as I've repeatedly said, I was assigned there as a vicar. I was not a prisoner.
Oh.
I just can't believe you'd lie.
I was not lying. It had no bearing on my ability to minister to my flock, and was therefore not worth mentioning.
Well, if he wasn't a prisoner, there's no issue. You don't like that he's worked at a prison? Alright. What else is around here? Good God, the poor devils. Ike's Armory? And there's Ike.
You look like someone who's taken their share of cuts and bruises. Need some armor. Maybe it's a bit secondhand, but that's only a testament to its durability. We also have a line of specialized melee weapons. For those times you have to repel boarders, but don't want to risk a bullet through the hull.
Are you a spacer yourself?
Not me, but it's in my blood. After the crossing, my family worked Eridanos, indentured to the corporations.
Go on.
I was born into corporate labor, but I'm the first one of my family to buy my way out. That's why I settled on Groundbreaker. It's the last bastion of freedom.
Tell me more about your wares.
Everything I sell is fresh from the forge. Technically, the metal formed billions of years ago, but it's freshly in the shape.
Right, I got it. So... you sell... wow... melee weapons I've not seen before. This is a plasma thing? Officer's spine. This one-handed sword is extremely sharp and exceptionally sturdy. Its scabbard is designed to coat the blade with acid as it's unsheathed, with vents along the blade to keep the blade coated while drawn, dealing corrosion damage to targets. I don't know if this is plasma. The origin of the name of this sword is lost in antiquity. Was it named Officer's Spine because officers could stand straight knowing they wielded his powerful swords? Or was it that, like officers, these swords vented noxious fumes? No one knows. Another one. Does it impact hammer that we've seen? Plasma cutter. Okay, this is plasma. Like the jingle says, don't put the pedal to the metal. Put an Aramid Ballistics Plasma Cutter there instead. Burns. Trip blade. Security blade. pulse hammer, seen the stuff tremor cleaver. And we've got armor. Standard troop armor. 19. Crew outfit. Port of call crew outfit model H is modern and stylish. A vast improvement on model G. Leather gear business. Lightweight leather jacket, a spacer's favorite. Daywear? Typically worn by spacers. Water-resistant wear? Surprisingly effective against corrosive material. Tech skills plus 5. Option 1. Hiking gear, quilted. Provides warmth and protection in a lightweight, fashionable style. Boots and gloves are included. Space aviator glasses. Spacer's goggles, great for protecting your eyes, not your head. This gives you a hack plus 5 bonus. Enclosed padded helm. Lightweight spacious helmet, full coverage for moderate protection. Do I have some stuff I want to sell? I know I picked up a few more things, but... yeah, sell this stuff. Knock you out bar, Rizzo. CCN76 milk chocolate bar with caramel and pea-free nuts in it. Yeah, that can be handy. Fish sticks. First ingredient is salt tuna. Purpleberry punch. Yeah, what's her name gave this to us. A soft sour candy shell around a sweet purpleberry flavored center. Well, this stuff I'll sell. That's how I get in trouble.
I picked up some weird chatter on my way in. Seemed to come from Monarch?
I guess about monsters? The Groundbreaker Promenade.
So far as you know, I'm not drinking on duty.
Yeah, as far as I know. What is this? Well, these are takes anyway. Auntie's kitchen key card. Thank you. And there's the kitchen.
If you got a complaint, file it at security.
Okay, good to know.
Don't look funny at the crew. Heard they toss folks out the airlock if they don't like your face.
Oh my. Greasy?
Hearty greeting, potential customer. Welcome to Auntie's Kitchen, a home-style consumable protein dispensary.